My granddad, the father of my father, he got into horses, and but only on more of a local level, local regional shows. But then now, my father actually brought up our stables up to international level. I mean, he competed himself for Olympic Games, so he was obviously very, very good. He was number two in the world.
I think the staff is very important at home as well. The riders and the grooms and all this is very good, and I think the structure is quite good. We just need to find the young horses, and I think I start riding them from when they are 7, 8 years old. I cannot do much more with them when they're younger than that. So I try to take them from then and produce them to the highest level, and that so far has worked quite well.
Like for example, my horse Extra, I rode him when he was 5 and he was 6, and then my Thibaut took it over when he was 7 and 8. Competed at the European Championships with it, won a gold medal on it, and then I took it back, and now I'm competing it on 5-star level. I mean that the system works pretty well, and he's done also a very good job with that.
I think I can always rely a lot on my parents back, for sure. They were always there for me, and I think that's still very important now. I mean, my father is not coming as much as before to the shows because I still have my younger brothers as well that needs a lot of training, but for sure on the important moments he will be there, and I think we can always rely on my father and my mother. My mother was always there behind the scenes.
Our horse business made sure we can do the sport. Without the business there was no sport for us, that's very, very clear. My father started up this big company, and then now Nicola and me, we are really getting into it. You know, we're still riding very intense with the sport, so we don't have so much time to do other things yet. We're lucky to have a few good partners like H&M and a few good owners that are trying to keep a couple horses for us to compete in the sport, which is also very, very important. I mean, without them, we will have to sell everything. And now we're able to keep a couple horses to really keep competing on top level.
It's one of the best things that could happen to Olivia and me. I think it's a great team. If a company like H&M or a family like H&M can stand behind us and support us in the sport, it's very good. I'm very glad to have them. And they're also very long-term thinking. If you see Peter and Malen there for years and years already sponsored, and I think it really helps in our sport to have them as a sponsor as well.
I do think it's not very easy to have a family business. It's not an easy thing, especially not because if you work in another business, you know, and you hire someone, you're not happy, you can find a different solution, find someone else, but when you're family, you have to do it together.
I think in every family there's an argue. I think it's sometimes it's necessary to have an argument to make it better, you know. If you never talk about the problems, you cannot solve them. So I think it's good sometimes we have argue about it, and then we try to come with a solution so we can solve it.
We're very, very close, and I think that's a big advantage. And we're really trying to set up a good partnership between all of each other, so we really know what we can do together and how we should also talk to each other when something goes wrong.
Each of us has his own side with his horses, and then we have one main rider that also when I'm showing, like sometimes I'm gone for 2-3 weeks, and the other rider also even jumps some horses of me, so the good ones he can jump, so then they're ready for me to come back and go to another show.
Legend of Love, she is now 13. I've had her since she's 7. She's also very she's a bit special, a bit grumpy, but her capabilities are extremely good. I mean, she has jumped lots of global tours, World Cup finals, and she won a lot of prize money. And she's really a special horse for me because, I mean, it's a horse I've known for a long time. And in the ring, she truly does everything for me to do it as good as possible. So for me, she still will be the number one.
Every great rider can adapt to every single horse. I think that's very important. Every horse is different, and you need to take it a little bit how it is. I think my main horse now is Chili Willy. Actually, he's a very cool horse, very nice. He's not stallion at all, but he needs a lot of attention. I think he's very spoiled. Like every time when I come in the stables in the morning, I give him an apple or a carrot, and he'll be standing already in front of the box waiting for that. He's been an amazing horse for me, and hopefully he can still be that for many years.
We both are living our sport on a top level, which is already very difficult. I think there's not one twin in our sport that does the same that we have done, so it's quite a unique style. I think we're quite happy with that.
We show nearly every week, so I think the pressure's on every week, and you need to adapt to that as well and just try to do a little bit your own thing. Don't think about the consequences, but just try to focus on your horses and do your best in the ring. You cannot do more than that.
So I think it's important also to pick out in these five-star shows someone you want to really perform well, because it's hard, very hard to perform good every single week. It's actually impossible. So it's always important to make sure you have a good plan and you work to certain points in your season and then try to get your horse on top of the game. I think that's very important. I always say, when you go in the ring and you lose your brain, you lose your game anyway, because it's always important, even if you want to go fast, or you got to stay focused and make sure you keep control of everything that's going on. I'm not the person that keeps looking back to the bad things. You know, what happens, it happens, and I think it's important. You also have to see what good parts are improving. Don't always look what it's bad. Try to see what went wrong, what you can do to not happen again. You have to be optimistic about it.
Everyone rides different, and I think you can learn from everyone. So if you have a problem with a horse, you need to try a lot of different systems or a lot of different possibilities to make the horse the best out of it. I have a lot of respect for different riders, how they do it and how they get there. But I also sometimes like to think a little bit my way and try to do my thing, for sure.